गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट एंड वेलकम बैक टू आवर इंग्लिश क्लास. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू रीड अ पोम फॉर यू एंड देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन द पोम फॉर यू. यू हैव टू लिसन द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पोम वेरी केयरफुली. नाउ स्टूडेंट गिव पे अटेंशन एंड यू कैन रीड आफ्टर मी ऑल्सो. ओके. द नेम ऑफ द poem is Why. I know a curious little boy who is always asking why. Why this, why that, why then, why now, why not, why, by the by. He wants to know why wood should swim, why lead and marble sink, why sun should shine and wind should blow, and why we eat and drink. He wants to know what makes the clouds and why they cross the sky. Why sinks the sun behind the hills and why the flowers die. Some of these whys are not too hard to answer if you will try. Others no one ever yet has found the reason why. Now, stanza 1. I will explain this stanza 1. I know a curious little boy who is always asking why. Why this, why that, why then, why now, why not, why, by the by. In this stanza, the poet tell about a curious boy. Curious means who want to know everything. Okay. In this first stanza, the poet tell about a little boy who is very curious, which means eager to know everything, means wants to know everything. He always keep on asking, why is this happening? Why is that happening? Why did not happen then? Why this happening now? As such other question about all the other things that he sees. Now second stanza. He wants to know why would should swim, why lead and marble sink, why sun should shine and wind should blow, and why we eat and drink. In this stanza, the poet continues to tell about the curiosity of the boy. He further wants to know why does wood swim? Why is lead and marble sink in water? Other questions asked by him are, why does sun shine and wind blows, and also why do we eat and drink? Okay, now third stanza. He wants to know what makes the clouds and why they cross the sky. Why sinks the sun behind the hills and why the flowers die. In this third stanza, poet gives also some examples of the question asked by the little boy. Okay. He wants to know the procedure of cloud formation and why do they cross the sky, why the cloud cross the sky, and why the sun set behind the hills. He also wants to know why the sun set behind the hills in the evening? And why the beautiful flowers in the garden die? Now, some of these whys are not too hard to answer if you will try. Others, no one ever yet has found the reason why. In this stanza, the poet is telling about the boy. Okay, some of these whys are not too hard. The poet is telling us the questions of the boy. Whys means questions. The some questions of the boys are not very hard. You can give the answer of his questions, but sometime his questions are very difficult. Understand? Questions are very difficult to answer. But some questions have no answer. Yet as no one has found them, no one can give the answer of the boy's question. So we have to accept them as fact. Understand what the poet want to say? The poet is saying in this stanza, if you will try to give the answer of boy's question, you can give, because these are the very easy question. But sometimes he asks very difficult question which we can't give the answer. Okay, understand the explanation of this poem. Now, here are some work of this lesson. This is your work. Contain difficult words. You have to write with a small letter, curious, lead, marble, sink, reason, behind, clouds. Then word meaning. Here are only 5 word meanings. You have to learn and write all these word meaning in your literature book. After this, question answer. Your first question is, name few things that sink. The answer, lead, marble, iron and stone. I written here lead, marble, iron and stone. But you can write here other name also, like copper, brass, hai na? You can write the name of that also. Question number 2. List 3 questions that the little boy asked. I am writing here 3 questions which the boy asks. But you can write here other question also. I written here the 3 questions that the little boy asks are, why wood should swim, why sun should shine, why wind should blow. You can write here other question as you like. Now here question number 3. What shot of a boy is described in the poem? Sad, curious, brave. The poem describes the boy as curious. Curious boy, na? So curious is your answer. Now here is some question. Think and write. Your first question is, why can't we look at the sun during a solar eclipse? Answer, we can't look at the sun during a solar eclipse as the sun radiation can harm our eyes. Third, why we can't touch the sun? We can't touch the sun because it is very far from us. Understand? Question 3. Why can't we go out to play in the dark? Your answer is, We can't go out to play in the dark because we will not able to see anything and can even fall down while playing. This is your think and write. And last is your make sentences. Here are four make sentences for you. Number one, curious. Sonakshi is very curious to know about the stars. Marble. Arnav and Gaurav are playing with marbles. Sink. My keys are sink in the water. Reason. Abhinav gave his reason for coming late. Student, this is your work of lesson. Why? You have to note down all the work in your literature notebook like me. Okay. I hope you understand the explanation of the lesson and about your work. This is your non-submission worksheet. Non-submission worksheet means you have not to submit this worksheet. You have to do only the work. Okay? Student, don't submit this worksheet. Okay? Stay home. Stay safe. Bye-bye. Thank you.